Hi guys, let's learn about the most of the times I focus more on fundamentals. A lot of people asking me, people keep asking me, why you focus on fundamentals more? Why don't you give us more insight into the very difficult techniques and all that stuff? But the difficult techniques, like for example, how to write a book, unless and until you don't know how to write words and make differences between phrases and clauses and your punctuation, grammars, how will you write a book? In the same way, these fundamentals are very, very, very important. So let's learn some fundamentals here. So I'm drawing an egg. I'm drawing an egg. Okay. So this is the basic outline of the egg. So a lot of people do not understand about the light properties, how it plays a huge role to instill life into our works. So this is how I got this particular idea of making this particular video, making people to understand how to make this basic structure. So now let us consider this as the egg and chip. Now consider the light is falling here. So when light is falling here, remember to draw from the darkest portions to the lightest portions. So that means from here, the darkest portion is here. So you are supposed to draw from the leftmost portion to the rightmost portion. Okay. Sorry, from rightmost portion to the leftmost portion here. Okay. So how will you start drawing? So basically use little pressure here on the edges because it is the darkest portion, and draw towards left. Use brush stroke. Do not use your tip, but the along side of the pencil. This will basically help you to avoid the sharp lines while you are drawing. See, it's like called brush stroke. You will get a kind of brush stroke with the help of pencil. Okay. So yeah, this is it. Now how well you create the dark tone? I am using only HB pencil, which is Apsara Extra Dark, which our children uses while they are learning ABCDs and while they are drawing in their school notes. A normal simple pencil. So that means it's all about how to utilize your material. The paraphernalia that you have in your hands is all about and it defines the professionalism of that particular artist. So I am creating another brush stroke which will actually helps us to see the darkest tone. So now I have been using cross hatch initially, but you will not see any cross hatch. Why? Because I am using brush stroke. So these are all the basic, very, very, very basic stuff. But if you do not understand this and start drawing anything and everything, since your basics are not strong, you will never ever see any improvement. And I keep saying in a lot of my videos, drawing every day is not that important when you are not drawing in a right way, because drawing in a right way is more important than drawing every day, practicing every day. So please remember this, practicing every day is important, if at all it is possible, but practicing in a right way, even if it is for a less amount of time, will add much more value to you as an artist and to the work that you are drawing. It gives so much of pleasure and happiness that you deliver a quality work in short span of time because you are practicing in right way. So as and when I come closer to the lightest area, I am using a very, very minimal pressure, and slowly if you start observing, you will not see any dark patches, if at all there are any dark patches, because of the pencil, because of the pigmentation that keeps falling out of the graphite, nothing wrong. You can take out with the help of the kneaded eraser like this. Take a small kneaded eraser piece, make it sharp and keep dabbing that particular area. It dies out, I mean it fades out. That means kneaded eraser will not eat, will not basically, the property of kneaded eraser is basically it will eat the graphite, it will eat the extra graphite. So as and when you press several number of times, that it tones down the graphite. That's it. Okay, now when it comes to here, I am using very very minimal pressure. So you have to be very careful here, do not ever use too much of pressure. And you might be watching me drawing strokes, but you don't see any pencil lines. It is all because of the, I am using the side, along side of the lead. So here in the bottom there is a little darkness, not too much, because you have to understand that this particular area is more darker, corner is more darker than this particular area, because this is more darker. Why? Because of the reflection light, reflection of the light, it is more darker. My paper might have spoiled here, that's the reason you might be seeing little patches here and there. But if you really wanted to get this tones proper, you have to add a little second tone, third tone, which will actually help you to get the right tone. If you really wanted to blend this particular egg, the beautiful way is to use an earbud with very minimal pressure. You don't have to use too much pressure. See, and use in circular way. This will actually make your life easy. It will make, see, there was a sharp edge here. Now you don't see that sharp edge. It is because you have blended it thoroughly, and do not use too much pressure, just a tad bit. Don't worry about this extra, I'll tell you how to correct it. Now I feel this particular area needs to be little toned to make it look more round, more circular. Okay, it looks much better now. Looks more round. Okay, now after this, the most important thing is in order to complement the amount of effort that you have put it on the egg, without background it will not be complemented. So the more you work on backgrounds, and the more you make the backgrounds look beautiful, the more your works actually look better. I am using only single pencil HP only to get the darkest tones, so I am using a little pressure, not too much. It's like layering over and over will set the tones, proper tones, whatever the tones that you want. Of course you might not get 8B tones or 6B tones, but having said that, your pressure should not spoil the paper. That's one important thing that one should remember. Whatever the pressure that you are actually using, with the pressure and laying down the tones 2-3 times will actually help you to get the darker tone. But you don't have to really spoil the paper with the help of the amount of pressure that you are putting. Keep this in mind. That's more important. Now, when it comes to the background, now here the trick is, this is a darker tone. On the rightmost side of the egg, and leftmost side is the lightest tone of the egg. Now, in order to complement, what does that mean, complement? Because in the nature, you have a light source from one side, and another side you will definitely see the darker area. Why? Because that light coming from one side will actually throw the side where the light is actually falling gets illuminated. But what about the other side? Other side will be dark. But now when you understand, light is falling on the egg, so that means it is hit here. This side it will be in darkness. But when it comes to the background is dark towards this side and light towards this side. Why? Because if it is dark this side, you will not know where the egg is ending, where is the egg's end portion. So that's complementing. So if it is light here, now anyway, since it is a white paper, you are able to see. But otherwise, it will be very difficult. In order to make the viewer perceive things, whatever the artist wanted to showcase, it is always better to use this contrasting techniques and complementing the contrasts. So it's called complementing the contrasts. So I am thoroughly explaining you the details and drawing so that you will understand. Now how do you draw? This is again a very tricky thing. Now this particular area is dark, light, so we are supposed to darken until this area. So mark the areas, outer portion or outline of the egg correctly. Do not use sharp edges. I am not using sharp edges, if you closely observe. So what I am trying to do is, most of the people, what they do wrong here is they will draw like this and they leave the white gaps here. It doesn't look nice. So you are supposed to blend the background with the edge. See, now it looks beautiful. So remember to blend the outline that you have drawn even before starting the background. Remember to blend it. So the best way to basically draw the background is to draw the cross edge. It quickly enriches your subject. And look at here, as and when I am going to the darker tone, I am lightening it. See, can you see? I am lightening this particular background. So I am using my pressure only here, until here. So practice thoroughly in such a way that you even if I am drawing fast, but I am not going beyond the boundary line of the egg. I am not getting into the egg. See, this is something which comes only through practice. The amount of love you have towards your work will always be shown here in your simple works, in your, you know, simple practice exercises, simple quick sketches, because this is how one develops interest towards making their works more beautiful. Because such people will not focus on what they are drawing. That means they're not too much worried about the apple or egg or pomegranate. They are worried about, they focus more about adding value to their work. What is their work? It could be anything. So focus more on adding beauty, adding, instilling life to your work, adding value to your work. Later, automatically it brings name, fame and all that, whatever you want. But this is more important. Love your work in such a way that people should carry an impression of your work, whether it is egg, pomegranate, apple, whatever it is, or a big beautiful portrait. People should be able to carry that impression, that beauty of your work in their mind for over a period of time to back to their homes. That's how one should basically focus on. So you should be able to create an impression. And for the amount of time they are viewing your work, they should forget their existence. They should basically engulf in your work. And they should forget looking at the beauty of your work. They should forget themselves. That's the beauty of arts. That's how arts are looked at. That's the reason people come to galleries to visit, because they would wanted to forget themselves. Why do people watch movies? Because they want to enjoy, forgetting themselves. They wanted to engross themselves into others, part of others' lives, other stories. In the same way, this art gallery is also, people would wanted to enjoy thoroughly looking at great master's work. So, yeah, you know, we don't basically compare ourselves to great masters, but we wanted to become such, we wanted to create such kind of work which great masters worked upon. What is the motto behind the great masters' work? It is all about advertising beauty, beauty, literature, knowledge, wisdom, sanity, virtues of our human beings. And if you are not actually following any of these things, I think then there is no meaning of producing beautiful work. What is it used for? I hope this makes sense to you now. Last but not least,